कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ टॉपिक प्रेशर, एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर, व्हाट इज एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर एग्जांपल, इफ दिस इज अ ग्राउंड, एयर विच इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन, कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड अदर इनर्ट गैसेस. So these particles are moving randomly so as these particles are moving randomly they hit the surface and when these particles the air particles hit the surface they exert force. So air particles are moving randomly collide with the surface exert force which create pressure. So what happened? These are the air particles or the air molecules. These air molecules or air particles are basically molecules of nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide. So it is moving randomly and continuously colliding with the surface. As they are hitting the surface, they exert force. And as they exert force, they will create a pressure, because whenever there is a force, there will be a pressure. What is this pressure? This pressure is known as atmospheric pressure. So the pressure exerted by the particles or the molecule of air is simply known as atmospheric pressure. And what is this value? You have to learn or memorize this value. At sea level or at the ground level, the pressure exerted by the particles of the air is about 100,000 Pascal, or you can say 1 × 5. This is the pressure at the sea level. This pressure varies as we move to higher altitude. Like example, a person is on the ground and then he climb a mountain. So which position you think the atmospheric pressure is higher, at the ground level, at the sea level, or at the mountain? Which position the pressure due to atmosphere is high, at A or B?
A.
At A, the pressure is high. What is the reason? Because the density of the air is more at a ground level. So as the density is higher, it will apply more pressure because more particles will collide. But as you move to higher altitude, as you climb a mountain, the number of the air particle or the density of the air decreases. There are less air particles, so less collision with the surface, so the pressure will decrease. So at sea level or at a ground level is also referred as a sea level. So at sea level, the pressure is higher. At the higher altitude, the pressure decreases. So if at the sea level, the standard atmospheric pressure, this is called 100,000 Pascal or 1 atm. You can also say 1 atmospheric pressure. So at sea level, if it is 1 atm or 1 atmospheric pressure, atm is also a unit of pressure, like Pascal is a unit of pressure. But the standard unit is Pascal or Newton per meter square. Other unit of pressure is atm. So if at sea level it is 1 atm, at higher altitude it is less than 1 atmospheric pressure or 1 atm. Is it clear? Any doubt in this? The concept of atmospheric pressure, because the gas particles are moving randomly. As they are moving randomly, they collide with the surface. They exert force on a unit area, which create a pressure. And this pressure value you have to learn, it's about 100,000 pascals. There is not a direct formula to calculate this pressure. Indirect, you can calculate this. I will show how you can calculate this atmospheric pressure, but not a direct formula. Take the screenshot, so I'll move on. So example, if you have a container which is filled with a liquid, the density of the liquid which you use is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. And the depth of the liquid inside the container is 1 meter. And the question is, calculate pressure exerted by liquid. So how to calculate pressure exerted by the liquid? So pressure exerted by the liquid is the density of a liquid into gravity into depth. So density of a liquid is 1000, gravity is 10, and depth is 1 meter. So when you multiply, it will be 10,000 pascal. But if the question is calculate the total pressure, at base of container. So what is the total pressure? Actually, there are two pressures acting here. Number one is the pressure of the liquid. And number two is the pressure of atmosphere. Because in the surrounding, we have air particles, and air particles are also colliding with the surface. So there are two pressures. One is due to atmosphere, and one is due to liquid. So in this case, when I need a total pressure, the total pressure will be the sum of atmospheric pressure plus pressure of the liquid. What is the atmospheric pressure? That's a fixed value which you have to learn or memorize, 100,000 pascal. So pressure of the atmosphere, I wrote PA, which is 100,000 pascal, plus pressure due to the liquid, it's 10,000. So this will be the total pressure. The total pressure is the sum of atmospheric pressure plus the liquid pressure. So if they ask in a question, calculate pressure exerted by the liquid, or pressure due to the liquid, or pressure due to the depth of the liquid, then you will use this formula, density, gravity, and height. But if the question is calculate total pressure and they provide you the atmospheric pressure. So then it will be the sum of atmospheric pressure plus the liquid pressure. Is it clear? Because the atmosphere is also exerting pressure and the liquid is also exerting pressure at the base. So the total pressure will be the sum of liquid pressure plus atmospheric pressure.
Sir, but air is also exerting pressure from right and left.
Yeah, but the thing is, the definition of a pressure, pressure is force acting on unit area. The force should be perpendicular. So the one which is perpendicular, that's force which create a pressure, that is 100,000 Pascal. The particles are moving randomly, but those particles which collide with the unit area, their pressure is 100,000 Pascal. Is it clear? Then how we can calculate atmospheric pressure? So instrument which is used to measure the pressure. So the instrument, the apparatus which we use to measure the atmospheric pressure, that is known as barometer. So barometer is used to measure the pressure exerted by the atmosphere or atmospheric pressure. A simple barometer, how it works, it is filled with the mercury and there's a inverted test tube. Now what happened, if these are the air particles, these air particles are continuously hitting the surface of the mercury. When they hit the surface of the mercury, what they create a pressure. As they create a pressure, they force this mercury to rise in the tube. So mercury is there in a large container, which is filled with a mercury, and this mercury surface is exposed to the atmosphere. So these air particles continuously hitting the surface of the mercury, as they continuously hit the surface of the mercury, the air particle force this mercury to rise in the tube. So the mercury will rise in the tube. It will rise to certain height and then it will stop. So when the mercury does not rise or stop, what does it mean? It means the pressure which the atmosphere is exerting balance with the pressure exerted by the liquid. Is it clear, the concept? So what happened in our atmosphere, we have air particles. These air particles are continuously moving randomly, so they hit the mercury surface. So as they hit the mercury surface, they force the mercury to rise in the tube or a container. So as the mercury rise in the container, it will rise to certain height and then it will stop. Why the mercury will stop rising? Because what happened, this side, now the mercury will apply a pressure or a liquid will apply a pressure, and other side atmosphere will apply a pressure. So when the atmospheric pressure is equal to the pressure exerted by the liquid, the mercury will not rise. So So there is a pressure exerted by the liquid and there is a pressure exerted by the atmosphere. Once the both pressures are balanced, so we can say the pressure of atmosphere is equals to pressure of the liquid. And what is the formula to calculate the pressure exerted by the liquid? The pressure exerted by the liquid is equals to density of the liquid into gravity into depth. But what depth we take for a barometer, in case of a barometer, the depth which we take, we don't take the full depth. We take how much the liquid rises in the tube. So level of the mercury in a container to a level of the mercury in a tube, we take that as a so this is a barometer is one of the device can be, there are many meters, different types of meter can be used to measure the atmospheric pressure, but this is a simple experimental way to identify or measure the atmospheric pressure. So what happened? The liquid is applying a pressure from one side and atmosphere is applying a pressure from other side. So when the pressure of the liquid and the pressure of atmosphere is same, it means the liquid pressure equal to atmospheric pressure. So we can find the liquid pressure. Example, if this depth was 0.76 meters, the density of the mercury is about 13,600. So pressure exerted by the liquid is equals to density of the liquid, which is 13,600. This is the density of a mercury. Multiplied by gravity, which is 10, multiplied by height. So what height we take? Height of the mercury in a container to a height of the mercury in a tube. So that's 0.76. When you multiply these values, what is the answer? 13,600 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 0.76. What's the answer?
103,360.
So this is the pressure exerted by the liquid. And if a question is, what is the pressure exerted by the atmosphere? So this will also be the pressure exerted by the atmosphere. So basically a mercury barometer or a barometer is used to find the pressure exerted by the atmosphere indirect way. How it used the indirect way? Because what happened as the mercury rise in the tube, so the mercury will stop rising when the pressure exerted by the atmosphere is equals to pressure exerted by the liquid. So we find the liquid pressure and the liquid pressure is same as the atmospheric pressure. So if you have a container which is filled with mercury, so barometer always consists of the mercury. In a barometer, we cannot find the atmospheric pressure without a liquid. Mercury barometer. There are different types, even different types of barometers. Some of the barometers are not using liquids. Without using a liquid, we can identify the pressure by the of the atmosphere. But a mercury barometer is using a mercury to identify the pressure exerted by the atmosphere. So you, if you have a container, this container is filled with mercury. And you inverted the tube. So when you invert this tube, the mercury in, and initially there should be a vacuum here. Why there should be a vacuum? Otherwise, if it was filled with air, the air will also push the mercury from the tube. That's why initially it should be a vacuum. So what happened? The atmosphere will force the mercury to rise in the tube. So the mercury will rise in the tube. If you want to calculate, if you want to calculate the pressure exerted by the atmosphere, so what height we take, we always take a height from a level of the mercury in a container to a level of the mercury in the tube. An example, if this height is 0.6 meters and the density of the mercury is 13,600 kilogram per meter cube. Now the question is calculate the atmospheric pressure. So how you calculate the atmospheric pressure? So in case of mercury, what is our assumption? That the mercury, the atmosphere is forcing the mercury to rise in the tube. The mercury will rise until the atmospheric pressure balances with the liquid pressure. So atmospheric pressure is equal to liquid pressure, and liquid pressure is density of a liquid multiplied by gravity multiplied by height. So density of the liquid is 13,600 multiplied by gravity is 10 and multiplied by height or depth. We are taking 0.6. Why I did not take the full depth? Why I did not take this full depth? I took only the difference in the depth. Why? Reason for that, because this site, the atmosphere, actually when we write it full, it should be in this manner, that atmosphere is exerting pressure, liquid is exerting pressure, and there is atmospheric pressure, liquid pressure from the right hand side. So there's the atmospheric pressure, liquid pressure from the left, and liquid pressure from the right. So this is a common distance for both. That's why we neglect that distance and we take the pressure of the atmosphere balanced with the pressure of the liquid. That's why we always measure the height from a level of the liquid in a container to a level of the liquid in the tube. We don't measure total, we measure the difference in the height. What's the answer for this? 13,600 multiplied by 10 multiplied by 0.6. So this is 81,600 pascal. The barometer part is not finished. Next class I will continue. Any doubt till now? The barometer, I will continue explanation tomorrow as well, because there are certain things related to barometer still left.
So, sir, in the exam, we will not be asked to find the find the atmospheric pressure. They will give us.
No, if they will give you the depth of the liquid and they ask find the atmospheric pressure. So the liquid pressure will be same as the atmospheric pressure here.
Sir, here we neglect the depth of the mercury because it was already occupied by the mercury before it rise.
Which part? Mohsin, can you repeat your question?
Sir, we neglect the depth before the rise because it's already been occupied by the mercury.
Yeah, we neglect, and basic idea is that we want that depth or height when the pressure of the atmosphere balanced with the liquid pressure. Before that, it was not balanced. That's why we neglect it. Is it clear?
Yeah, okay, sir. Yeah, thank you, sir.
Any doubt related to barometer? Okay, so tomorrow also I will continue this barometer. Still, it's not finished. The barometer, and there's a device called a manometer. These two devices, and then we'll finish this topic of pressure. So I'll end the session and share the recording with you.